Okay, so it looks like that our infield is getting firm enough we can walk on it. We're not leaving a lot of deep depressions. And we're kind of in a hurry to get this field dried out. We've got games coming up fairly shortly. We want to open it up to dry it out. Now, one option is to bring out a piece of equipment to scarify this, but if it's not firm enough and you come out here to scarify that with that piece of equipment, you're going to do more damage than you are good. So sometimes if you're still leaving just slight foot impressions, I would recommend you come out and open it up by hand. And we do that by what we call back raking. We take a rake, and instead of working in the forward direction to cut that soil like we normally would, we're actually going to rake in reverse and push the rake backwards. And by doing that, we cut these nice little trenches into the soil that opens it up and allows it to breathe. Pretty simple. I'm not putting a lot of down pressure down on there. We're just trying to cut in there about a quarter to a half inch deep, no deeper than that, to open it up, allow the air to get down into that soil, and depending on what your sun and wind conditions are for that particular time, it'll dry that out a lot faster than if you just leave it sitting tight like this. Now, if you are expecting rain later that evening, you might want to keep it tight and leave it just like it is here and allow that top dressing to dry out. Maybe you just want to fluff the top dressing a little bit. In that case, you can just run a cocoa mat drag over here to soften that up. But if you really need to dry that soil out a little bit, use that back rake procedure, and that'll work really great for you. And without all the muss and fuss of bringing a piece of equipment out here to drive around on it, and then you got the tires digging it all up.